In today's tutorial, I will show you how to align an object to a spline path inside of Cinema 4D. Let's begin. For this tutorial, I will be using this plane. Before I begin, I want to animate the propeller of this plane. So I will head over to my plane model and select the propeller layer. Once selected, I will head over to the coordinate tab and change the values for RB. Make sure you're at the beginning of your timeline and add a keyframe. Then move to the end of your timeline. Here, I will change the value to 3000 and I'll add another keyframe. Now, when I preview it, I can see the propeller move. However, I don't like that it stops and then starts again. So I am going to change both of my keyframes' interpolation to linear. And now, when I preview the animation, the propellers now move in a perfect loop. This looks good. It's time to create the path for the plane. Head over to the Pen Spline menu and select the circle spline. Once it's in your scene, go ahead and change the orientation by selecting the Objects tab and where it says Plane, change it to XC. Your circle spline will have now lay flat. I am going to scale mine a bit bigger. This looks good. I now want to change the shape of it, but first I need to make it editable. I'll go ahead and select this icon here. Perfect. Now I will go ahead and use point mode. I'll select this point here and do shift click to also select this point here. I'll move them up a bit. This looks good enough. Okay, it's time to attach my 3D object to this path we created. Go ahead and select your 3D object and do a right mouse click. Head over to animation tags and select align to spline. Now in the attributes window, head over to the spline path section, and here is where we will add the circle spline we created. Go ahead and drag the circle spline here. Perfect. You can now see our 3D object has attached itself to our circle spline. When I move the position bar, you can see our 3D object moves around the path. But I want my 3D object to follow the direction of the path. To do that, go ahead and activate the tangential box. And now we can see our 3D object follow the path's direction. Okay, it's now time to animate the movement. I'll make sure I am at the beginning of my timeline. I will also make sure the value is at 100. And I'll add a keyframe to the position. I'll move to the end of my timeline and make the position value be 0. And I'll add another keyframe. Now, when I preview the animation, I can see the plane go in circles. However, I don't like that it slows down when it reaches the end and then starts and takes off again. So I will go ahead and change the interpolation settings to both keyframes. I'll select the last keyframe and change the interpolation to linear. And I'll do the same for the first keyframe. Now, when I preview the animation, we can see my plane object go around in circles with the propeller rotating. But what if I want to use another path? Well, all you have to do is create the path you want. I will head over to the Pen Spline menu and I'll select a helix spline. I'll change the settings accordingly to what I want. And then I'll select this icon here. Once selected, I will drag my new helix spline to the spline path section and replace the circle spline I had originally. And now when I play it, you can see how my plane object follows this new path. And there you have it. You now know how to align a 3D object to a spline path inside of Cinema 4D. If you would like to download this project file, head over to the Tutu's Gumroad page. You can find the link in the video description. If you found this video helpful, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel. Till the next one.